Hello and welcome to Golgota University e-learning platform. I am Mehak Pandit, Assistant Professor of the Department of Mass Communication at Golgota University, and I'm also the course coordinator for the subject Event Management, which I teach in Bachelor's in Journalism and Mass Communication as well as Master's in Journalism and Mass Communication. So, of course, we have covered a lot of syllabi, and in today's video lecture, we're going to focus on a very, very important topic, that is risk management. Because when it comes to event planning, of course, in the previous video lectures, we have learned about the process of event planning, wherein we have talked about pre-event planning, during the event planning, and then the post-event planning. Of course, you have a foolproof plan of having a successful event, but when you do the event planning, it is very important to analyze before the happening of event that what kind of risk, you know, eventually could lead to ruining your so-called successful event. So in today's video lecture, we're going to learn about it in detail. Let us begin. So to begin with, we need to firstly understand that what do you mean by risk. So according to Merriam-Webster dictionary, basically risk is the possibility or the level of possibility for a loss or injury that could occur at your particular event. Of course, I'm going to take everything to the context of event management because we are studying this topic in the course of the event management. So the possibility of loss or injury that could occur during the event, of course, is called risk. Then it could also indicate about something or someone who could eventually lead to hazard or injury or loss at your event. Of course, there are three level of risk in particular template, because being an event manager, you need to actually create a template of the number of risk that I'm going to discuss, of course, in the further slides in this video lecture. So you need to grade the level of risk according to, you know, suppose if there is some issue like a rain could occur and there's a prediction. So you need to see that, you know, how correct is your prediction. So what is your level? It is low level or medium or high, you know, in context of rain, low chances, medium chances or high chances. So if it occurs, then what would you do in your particular event, right? So simultaneously, that is how the event manager has to understand that, you know, in case the level is high, then of course you need to take the decision that way, right? So that is what we mean by risk in event management. So now that you have understood the concept of risk, which is of course the first step, a first responsibility of the event management team to understand if there is any risk involved, and of course if you know, if you have the experience of organizing successful events, it doesn't mean that there could be no risk. Of course, every event management team makes sure, no matter what kind of foolproof plan they make, they always do risk management, because you never know what could happen and lead to or harm the life or create a loss or injury to anybody who is part of your event. It could be your staff as well. So of course, you as a team are responsible for that. So that is what wherein the risk management comes in. Basically, risk management is the act of reducing or eliminating the risk associated with involvement in any kind of event, no matter it's a corporate event or academic event or, you know, personal event like in form of wedding or any kind of celebration, right? So for event planners, risk can run from the gamut from being less serious to being very, very, very serious, depending upon the level it is. So of course it could be equipment or power failure, then medical emergencies. Of course you need to keep the first aid kit ready, and of course depending on the level of event it is, then of course the ambulance ready depending on the target audience, you know, all of that. Then sponsorship withdrawal, of course this is very important. Sponsorship withdrawal could happen maybe 2 days earlier, 1 day earlier, or because of some fight that happened. So it is also part of the risk management. Then fires and floods and last minute cancellations of tickets because of weather conditions or whatsoever it could be. Then food safety concerns, of course it is very, very important. So these may be severe weather conditions or natural disasters, and finally financial troubles. So I think all of the things that I've mentioned, of course, it is not comprehensive. I might have missed something, but you can see just a few of any kind of risk, that are inherent to hosting a special event. They can span many areas of your event, including attendees, food, beverage, arrangement, infrastructure, logistics, transportation, financing, marketing. You know, every department could face any kind of issues, and that might pop up, at the earlier stage or, whenever you plan. So now how to handle all of that is also the part of risk management that we're going to just study. So now that we have understood the concept of risk management, let us now learn about the type of risk that could happen in your event. So as you can see on your screens, there are four type of risk. First is the opportunity risk, then comes the risk of uncertainty, then risk of hazards, and finally the operational risk. So let us learn about each type of risk in detail. So as the name suggests, opportunity risk is very similar to the opportunity cost, but because here specifically we are talking about risk, so let us know about that. So let us assume that you plan to do a particular event wherein you have a certain amount of profit that you are expecting to generate, and as soon as you close the deal, the very next moment, a very excellent opportunity comes up for you on a similar date, then what would you do? This is called the opportunity risk, because of course standing by your words is equally important. So basically, when an organization decides to engage themselves or their resources in a particular option, the organization stands a chance to either losing a better opportunity, like I've already told you, or failing to deliver, or may even not generate the kind of profit that they were expecting during the inception. So this is your opportunity risk. Of course, it is very much dependent upon how foolproof or how experienced is the manager who is deciding the opportunities that are coming up your way. Second is the risk of uncertainty. So as the name indicates, or the word uncertainty indicates, this kind of risks are very uncertain, and it arises from the luck of circumstances that may intervene in our typical day-to-day activities, and moreover, these risks can't be controlled due to its uncertainty. However, these can be insured against so that the damage is compensated for, like natural calamities, fire, market downfall, decrease in the market share, that could happen, maybe when you're finalizing on Monday, and it could happen on Wednesday, legal actions, political unrest, which includes terrorist attack as well. So these are the best example of risk of uncertainty, and eventually these are not something that are in your hand, so they are more associated with the luck, right? Then comes the risk of hazard, which is very much in your hand, and they refer to the dangers that can arise out of improper handling or poor workplace design, resulting in dangerous events that can result in severe damage to the people who are attending the event or are in the organization team or your client yourself. So it may occur due to biological, physiological, chemical hazard, or improper allocation of duties depending upon the skills. Now again, it becomes the responsibility of the event manager to ultimately understand the kind of potential a particular individual has, and only then decide the kind of responsibility he's giving for. And if he experiments with someone's area, then he would surely give somebody to assist him or guide him for a particular activity, so there are limited chances of risk. Of course, a very popular example of risk hazard is the disaster that occurred in 1986, the worst nuclear disaster that shook the complete world and which has the lasting impacts, and the event triggered due to failure of skilled workers being present at the right time, which led to such situation. Of course, I think we all know. The fourth type of risk, of course, post the risk of hazard, is your operational risk. So basically, your operational risk is the risk that is involved in our day-to-day business activities, and it may arise out of failed procedures, systems, or policies. And it could also occur because there are certain operations which are required to the functioning of the business. So So after analyzing the type of risk, the level of risk, and the number of risk involved in your particular event, of course, event safety risk control plan template that you can see on your screen is usually used by the team to fill in as they do their planning process. That is in the first stage, that is pre-planning. As you can see on your screens, the template shows the name of event, date and time of event. The event manager's name is, of course, is very important, his phone number, because he is the main person who is responsible for a particular event. Then the exact location of the event, the exact number of expected attendees, and the person completing risk assessment, yani the person who is eventually doing the risk assessment, right? Then the kind of issues that are, you know, generally foreseen by a particular manager or the person who is doing, he names the type of task in of course this line. Then what could go wrong is mentioned here. Then who could, you know, be affected or impacted because of this is happened in the third. Then risk rating, of course, high, medium, low, right? So, and then risk control measures that can be taken or have already been taken should be mentioned here. And who is the person responsible for that particular control measure, and then if there is any pointer should be mentioned here, right? So this is eventually the template that could be filled by the event management team or the risk assessment team and could be analyzed and further decision. So now that we have understood the concept of risk, I discussed one of the thing called risk grading in the previous slide, wherein I told you that how the risk assessment team ultimately analyze the level of events. So of course, for analyzing the level of risk, it becomes very important for the person who is assessing to ultimately understand what is risk assessment matrix, right? So as you can see on your screens, I have mentioned how they decide the grade of a particular risk. Before that, let's understand what is risk assessment. So basically, risk assessment is the process of estimating the potential effects or harm of a hazard that to determine is risk rating, right? Or grading, in my words. By determining the level of risk, event organizers can prioritize risks to ensure systematic elimination or minimalization at their own level. So in order to determine the risk, they consider the matrix on the basis of the likelihood, then what would happen, the extent of harm, and the chances or possibility of it occurrence, right? So this is what is risk assessment. So as you can see on your screens, very clearly, the consequences or the rating is done on the basis of ratings like E, H, M, and L, wherein E refers to the estimate risk, immediate estimate risk, of course, in which the immediate action is required. Then comes the high risk, in which senior management attention is required. Then comes the M, that is moderate risk, wherein management responsibility must be specified, that who, you know, wanna take responsibility of that. Finally comes L, wherein it is low risk, wherein that could be managed by the routine procedures itself. Right? So basically, the levels are like the likelihood, the which could be insignificant, minor, moderate, major, or maybe the at the highest level. So of course, what to do for the highest level that I've already indicated. So this is about the risk assessment matrix on the basis of which the risk assessing team and the event manager takes their decision about the risk. So in today's video lecture, we have learned in detail about the risk management and how, you know, to cater to the type of risk involved, to the level, grading, risk assessment matrix. That was a very important topic. So now on your screen, what you can see are the references that I've used in creating this video lecture, as well as it includes the suggested readings. So I hope this video lecture was useful to you. For any further queries, of course, you can contact me on my mentioned email ID and mobile number. So till then, take care, stay tuned.